Hi, and welcome back to Calix Sustainable Aquaculture Series. We hope you enjoyed our first three episodes, and it's great to have you back for more. In this series, we explore different aspects of aquaculture and define key characteristics of a more sustainable approach to aquaculture. Sustainable aquaculture is possible with the right mindset and innovative technologies. Today, we'll be looking at an alternative aquaculture method, which not only controls harmful products formed during shrimp culture, but also utilises these waste products to help in the production process. I am pleased to finally introduce the Aquacal Plus process. Aquacal Plus offers a more sustainable approach to pond aquaculture. Aquacal Plus is a modified magnesium hydroxide liquid, commonly called MHL, specifically produced for water table and pond bottom conditioning in aquaculture ponds. Aquacal Plus is applied by direct dosing into aquaculture ponds at specific dosage and time intervals. Dosage can vary depending on prevailing pond conditions and stock densities. With multiple modes of action, high surface area and levels of reactivity, Aquacal Plus enables the precipitation of suspended solids and the effective binding of dissolved or suspended metals such as iron. This is critical for iron-sensitive species such as shrimp post-larvae and the microorganisms they feed on. Aquacal Plus's reactivity and high surface area has been proven to bind free ammonia and phosphate in situ within each tiny particle of Aquacal Plus. By controlling the generation of free ammonia from the pond bottom sludge, we prevent the production of nitrite, which is the next step in the natural nitrification cycle, which is harmful to aquatic life. Phosphate is released from feed and runoff from surrounding agricultural areas, and if left untreated, can cause severe and harmful algae blooms, such as blue-green algae and filamentous algae. Because phosphate binds on the Aquacal Plus particle, we can manage these algae challenges a lot more efficiently. Aquacal Plus's formulation also contains calcium, which is crucial for the formation of crustacean exoskeleton and fish bones. Finally, Aquacal Plus is a safe and environmentally friendly source of alkalinity, an important requirement for pond water health and conditioning. Let's now have a look at the physical attributes of Aquacal Plus, which is essential if we want to understand the roles Aquacal Plus plays in the Struvite reaction. Here, you are looking at Calyx magnesium oxide under the microscope. This unique honeycomb structure is what gives Calyx products their exceptional qualities. Calyx magnesium oxide has a surface area of 300 to 350 square meters per gram, which puts it into the nanoactive area of functionality, without the associated concerns of nano-size products. This magnesium oxide is then reacted by hydration to form magnesium hydroxide. Here, Aquacal Plus, in a 60% slurry form for better ease of application. Let's have a look at the Struvite reaction, which is also known as magnesium ammonium phosphate. This reaction takes place when Aquacal Plus is added to the water. Struvite is precipitated, taking out ammonia and phosphate, and at the same time absorbing iron into the struvite while precipitating suspended solids. This gives much better clarity to the pond. Once the struvite is precipitated to the pond bottom, the struvite reaction continues absorbing ammonia as it is formed, and phosphate as it is released from the feed. This reaction is a substitution reaction. Ammonia and phosphate in and OH ions out. This means that oxygen is released into the system. This oxygen converts the predominantly anaerobic digestion that is taking place in the pond bottom sludge to aerobic. Subsequently, the sludge is digested more rapidly than with other current culture methods, and excess oxygen is released into the pond water. We have readings that show a definite dissolved oxygen, or DO, bounce after application of AquaCal Plus. For the farmer, it means they may be able to reduce the use of aeration, thus decreasing power usage while maintaining a good level of dissolved oxygen in their pond. So, what is the mode of operation for AquaCal Plus? At any given time in a pond bottom, there are two systems operating simultaneously, anaerobic and aerobic digestion. These are natural processes for the breakdown of organic matter, and both produce harmful bioproducts for aquaculture. AquaCal Plus works by releasing oxygen in the form of OH ions while increasing the pH at the bottom of the pond. This is what pushes the digestion towards the aerobic process, and what explains the suppression of hydrogen sulfide, H2S, that bad rotten egg smell, often encountered at the end of the grow-out. By increasing the pH, we modify the conditions at the bottom of the pond, making it less conducive for the generation of pathogens. The aerobic process produces a harmful bioproduct that is ammonia, which will naturally convert to nitrite via a process called the nitrification cycle. Nitrite, at concentrations as low as 2 ppm, parts per million, can be harmful to many aquatic organisms. And because it uses oxygen as part of its conversion process, it also puts a strain on aeration systems to maintain good dissolved oxygen levels. AquaCal Plus absorbs ammonia as it is formed while absorbing phosphate from the feed to form struvite. This has multiple benefits. 1. The removal of ammonia. 2. No ammonia means no nitrites. 3. By stopping the nitrification cycle, the system's demand for dissolved oxygen, DO, is reduced, making it easier to maintain good dissolved oxygen levels in the pond. And 4. The struvite formed is an excellent slow-release fertilizer that encourages the growth of beneficial algae which shrimp and fish can use as supplementary feed. This, in turn, can reduce the quantity of synthetic feed needed throughout the crop, effectively reducing the FCR, feed conversion ratio. It has been documented that shrimp, particularly in the early stages of culture, prefer natural food over synthetic feed. Gut analysis of shrimp later in the culture has shown up to 30% of natural algae uptake. H2S production ceases in an AquaCal Plus pond. This particular pond is a monodon pond without drainage and where farmers used probiotic and water exchange. At the end of the culture, the bottom sludge was anoxic. This means black, gelatinous, with a low pH of around 4 to 4.5 and a very bad smell of hydrogen sulfide. After using AquaCal Plus, the hydrogen sulfide smell had disappeared. The sludge was no longer gelatinous. We analyzed the pond bottom and the pH was over 6. The white-colored substance you see here is struvite. Struvite doesn't really need to be dredged as it can be spread and used to fertilize the next crop. The farmer also observed that his residual sludge, after using Aquacal Plus, was significantly reduced by more than a third compared to his usual culture. And because Monodon are bottom feeders, he was then able to increase his stock density. This meant he increased his stock density from 30 pieces per square meter to 45 per square meter. Now let's look at some results from Vanamai, commonly known as the Pacific white shrimp, in fully lined ponds. The control here was the standard culture method with probiotics and daily drainage after 21 days. The DOC, or days of culture, was 120 days. In the first Aquacal Plus pond, Aquacal Plus was dosed at a rate of 20 parts per million on water volume for pre-treatment, and then at 4 ppm on a weekly basis. Drainage was done once per week after 21 days. In the second Aquacal Plus pond, similar conditions were followed, but the drainage was done monthly after 21 days. Results: the average body weight, or ABW, increased in both Aquacal Plus ponds. The survival rate was increased in both ponds. The feed conversion ratio, FCR, was significantly reduced in both ponds. The harvest weight was significantly increased in both ponds. Last but not least, revenue significantly increased in both ponds by 26 and 21% respectively. Aquacal Plus offers multiple benefits to the farmer. It is a natural mineral. It ensures a more stable pH. It increases alkalinity. It helps with the suppression of ammonia, iron, and sulfide. It encourages the formation of struvite fertilizer, which is good for algae. Aquacal Plus helps maintain a healthy pond bottom. It breaks down fats. It reduces food conversion ratio and increases survival rate while significantly reducing the environmental footprint of the farm. Hopefully you are still with me. I'd like to show you how Aquacal Plus compares with other current pond practices. Please note that this study was done in Malaysia, and all monetary values we will be observing here are in Malaysian ringgit. We will be looking at two different ponds. The first commercial pond was an earthen pond with little sludge drainage but regular water exchange. The second commercial pond was a clear water system in a lined pond with daily sludge drainage and water exchange. The Aquacal Plus pond was an earthen pond with no sludge drainage and minimal water exchange. Now let's compare the three culture types. Because this is such a busy slide, let's take a moment to look at it before I explain the differences we observed between the three ponds. These results are a combination of field results and online information and are given here as a guide. If we focus on the key aspects of the culture, firstly, when looking at feed, we look at a combination of stock density and practices. As you can see, the second commercial pond uses more feed. Not only is the stock density higher, but there is no natural feed in the system. Secondly, food conversion ratio. Here, you can see that the typical FCR is lower in the Aquacal Plus pond. This is because it works on a green water system and it generates algae for shrimp feed. Third, chemical usage. Here, the second commercial pond is the highest in chemical usage, as it relies on the clarification of water using a chemical process. In contrast, in the Aquacal Plus pond, the main cost was the cost of Aquacal Plus. And fourthly, electricity usage. This is another area where we see a large difference in costs between ponds. As Aquacal Plus does not rely on sludge drainage and water exchange, it was by far the most economical in regards to electricity usage. Electricity is usually one of the largest cost inputs, so not a negligible benefit. Now, when we look at the cost of production, we can easily see that the first commercial pond ended up being the cheapest, followed closely by the Aquacal Plus pond, while the second commercial pond resulted in much higher shrimp production costs. Beyond costs, the most important factor for many farmers is the net profit they can extract from their culture. As far as net profit goes, the Aquacal Plus pond is performing well ahead of both commercial ponds. In simple terms, this means the farmer can make more profit with less outlay using Calix's Aquacal Plus. One factor that was not taken into consideration was that the second commercial pond also uses more of the farm area for water clarification. This can cut into the available area for production. Finally, let's compare potentials for disease in our three ponds. It is accepted that the more water exchange, particularly in high-density farm areas, the greater the risk of infection. Because Aquacal Plus utilises the least water exchange, it presents the smallest risk in terms of infection and disease spread. In conclusion, we've seen that Aquacal Plus is the most economical solution when compared with other systems. Not only does it reduce the chance of introducing disease into the pond, but, if suitably dosed, can also reduce overall environmental impact of the farm. With passion and a purpose of solving global challenges, Calix has developed Aquacal Plus, a water conditioner that safely works to reduce the likelihood of disease, improves productivity, and ultimately your profitability. A more sustainable industry means aquaculture and shrimp farming can become a more efficient way of growing food and feed the protein needs of a growing human population. For more information on Calix's Aquacal Plus or for detailed protocols, please contact our partners and distributors in your region. Because, as we like to say here at Calix, there's only one Earth and it's already ours. Mars is for quitters. Thanks for your attention. We hope you found this video interesting, and I hope you'll join me again for the next episode of this series on sustainable aquaculture. To find out how Calix can help, or discover the benefits of Aquacal Plus for shrimp farming, visit our website, www.calix.global.